going into the next topic. We will going into the current topic, that is weathering topic. Okay, I am going to share my screen here. See the screen sharing. Yes. So the weathering and its types. Weathering and its types. First, you have to know what is the definition of a weathering. Content of this present topic is weathering, types of weathering, mechanical weathering, chemical weathering, biological weathering, and types are there in the weathering. Okay. First, what is weathering? Weathering is nothing but a breakdown of rocks. As simple as weathering is nothing but a breakdown of rocks under the influence of geological agents. Weathering is nothing but breakdown of rocks. Anything if you put outside which is in contact with the atmosphere, generally the strength of that material will decrease day by day. Why? Because there is always the gases which are there in the atmosphere tries to react with the material in the material that you placed outside. That's why the chemical reaction between the atmospheric gases and the rocks is a continuous process. Due to the chemical reactions, the atmospheric gases and the material, the minerals which were there in the rock are always in interaction. That's why the rocks will lose their strength because of the chemical reaction. For example, if you put an iron rod in the atmosphere, that is outside, then there is a chemical reaction will happen between the oxygen and the iron which were there in the iron rod and oxygen in the atmosphere. Due to that thing, the rust will come on the top of the iron surface. That's why if that iron rod keep on exposed to the surface, then it will be, become a rust. That's why chemical reactions between minerals and atmospheric gases plays an important role in the weathering process. Okay, chemical reaction between the minerals and water, that is H2O, plays a crucial role in the atmospheric crucial role in the weathering process. Chemical reaction between the glacier, nothing but ice, and minerals plays a crucial role in the weathering process. So weathering is nothing but a physical breakdown of rock and chemical breakdown of rocks. All will include weathering. Weathering is nothing but a breakdown of rocks. Weathering is nothing but a breakdown of rocks. So we will move to the slide. So weathering, there were benefits. There are many benefits from weathering and there are many disadvantages from the weathering also. Advantages are there and disadvantages are there. For example, I would like to suggest one example. So everybody needs water for their survival. So water, surface waters are not uniformly distributed because the rivers are, choosing their paths basing on the topographic elevations. Whereas some areas are rich with water resources, some areas are not rich with water resources. In that case, you have to depend on the groundwater for your survival. For example, if you take Krishna district, Krishna district is blessed with Krishna River. Whereas in the case of Anantapur district, you are not finding any river because there are no big rivers like Krishna were there in Anantapur district. That's why there in Anantapur district, people should depend on groundwater for their survival. Likewise, groundwater occurrence will take place only in the weathering zones only. So in this case, weathering is advantageous weathering is advantageous. Weathered rocks will withstand the water, whereas in the case of weathering zones, whereas in the case of weathering zones for, you know, causes, you know, serious disturbances in the construction site. In that case, weathering zones are disadvantages. Weathering zones for disadvantages. So weathering zones for advantages in the case of groundwater point of view, weathering zones for disadvantages in the case of construction point of view. Okay, see the difference between, you know, weathering zones there in the construction site and there in the there to pump a well in a region. Okay, so I hope you understood the definition. Weathering is nothing but a breakdown of rocks, whether that breakdown may be in a mechanical way or that breakdown may be in the chemical way. So breakdown of rock is known as the simply weathering. Breakdown of rock is known as simply weathering. For a civil engineer, weathering process is very important because he has to identify weathering zones in the so many regions because those weathering zones pose threats to the construction. That's why before going to construction of the any reservoir or dam or tunnel, weathering zones should be identified and demarcated, and those should be you know dug from that place, and those areas should be lined with the concrete or filled with the concrete, where in the case of reservoir, because weathering zones creates leakages in the reservoir. That's why weathering zones were not to be fit or not to be suitable in the reservoir site. So here the definition will come. I already told you, weathering process occurs at or near the earth surface and produce changes to the landscape that influence surface and subsurface topography and landform developing. So weathering is the physical disintegration, the chemical alteration of rocks are near the earth surface. Erosion is the physical removal of the transportation of weathered material by water, wind or gravity. So physical and chemical process that break down rock on earth surface. This is the diagram. I already told you the definition. Weathering occurs on the surface of the earth or nearer to the surface of the earth. And weathering nothing but a physical breakdown of rocks and chemical breakdown of rocks, both considered as weathering. In weathering, simply you understood that breakdown of rocks will happen. What is a rock actually? I forgot to tell you the definition. What is a rock actually? Rock is made up of minerals and it is a building block of earth crust. Rock is nothing but made up of with minerals and a building block of earth crust. Okay. So weathering is occurring on nearer to the surface because of the chemical reactions between water and rock and air and rock and glacier and rock. Due to weathering, rock will broken into pieces. So I would like to give you some suggestions here. So disintegration, decomposition are the main parts of the weathering. Disintegration means mechanical weathering. By means of mechanical weathering, there is no interaction of any chemical process there, only physically rock will broken into pieces. Whereas in the case of decomposition, there is a chemical alteration takes place. There, chemical alteration plays an important role in breaking the rock. Okay. Chemical alteration takes place in breaking the rock into pieces. What is meant by erosion? The removal of material from one place to another place is known as the weathering. The removal of material from one place to another place is weathering. Okay. Erosion is nothing but the removal of one place material from one place to another place is known as the erosion. Erosion was taken place by the water, wind or ice or gravity. the broken pieces, if those broken pieces were traveled from one place to another place, then it is known as erosion. So weathering is physical breakdown of rocks and chemical breakdown of rocks. Both will known as the weathering. And erosion is nothing but a removal of transportation weathered material by water, wind and ice, ice or gravity. So see, you are seeing the diagram now. This is the physical and chemical process that break down the rock on the earth surface. Next, types of weathering. I already told you there were two types: mechanical weathering or physical weathering. And this is because of some technical problems. It is like that only: chemical weathering and biological weathering. First one is mechanical weathering, second one is chemical weathering, and third one is biological weathering. So in the mechanical weathering is the physical disintegration and reduction in size of the rocks without changing their chemical composition. I already told you, you are not experiencing any chemical change here. By means of physical action, the rocks will broken into pieces, and those pieces will be transported from one place to another place under the influence of erosion. Examples for the mechanical weathering is exfoliation, frost wedging, salt wedging, temperature changes and abrasion. Whereas the chemical weathering are nothing but a chemical erosion, chemical weathering decomposes or dissolves or alters or weakens the rock through chemical process to form residual material. Examples is carbonation, hydration and hydrolysis, oxidation, solution. Biological weathering is the disintegration of decay of rocks and minerals caused by the chemical or physical agents of organism. Examples: organic activity from lichen and algae, rock disintegration by plant or root growth or burrowing and tunneling organisms and acid secretion. So these were the basic three types of weathering: mechanical weathering or physical weathering, chemical weathering or decomposition. Mechanical weathering is also known as the disintegration, and biological weathering. Biological weathering by means of biomes, by means of organisms, weathering process will be continued. Weathering, whenever the term weathering comes into your minds, nothing but it is a breakdown. Weathering equal to breakdown. I'll write you here. Wait for 1 minute. So weathering equal to nothing but breakdown. Breakdown of what? Breakdown of rocks. Weathering means breakdown of rocks. Simply, breakdown of rocks are known. Breakdown of rock is known as the weathering. So for example. So assume this rectangle is a rock piece. Under the influence of weathering, this rock piece broken into many pieces. This thing is known as the weathering. Weathering is equal to nothing but breakdown of rocks. So due to this breakdown of rocks, weathering plays an important role from the civil engineering point of view. And from the civil engineering point of view, it plays a disadvantageous role. From the other groundwater point of view, it plays an important role, it plays an advantageous role. Okay, keep that in mind. Weathering is nothing but breakdown of rocks. So breakdown will occur as two types. Physical weathering and chemical weathering. Chemical weathering, physical weathering. Physical weathering. Also, one more weathering is there. That is biological weathering. That is biological weathering. So weathering is nothing but breakdown of rocks. Breakdown of rocks happen in three types: physical weathering, chemical weathering, and biological weathering. Physical weathering, there is no question of chemical activity. There is no question of chemical activity. By applying external force, rock will broken into so many pieces. For example, under the influence of gravity, these landslides will collapse onto the foothills. Due to that collapse, the foothill rocks broken into number of pieces. Only by the influence of gravity, the huge rock falls on the foothill region. The rocks which were there on the foothill region broken into smaller pieces under the influence of gravity. In that case, only the physical activity done. That's why that is known as a physical weathering. Whereas in the case of chemical weathering, if water is contacted with the limestone, then if water is contacted with the limestone, then the water will, you know, water will dissolve the limestone. That limestone broken into smaller pieces, or limestone, you know, going into water by dissolving thing. That's why limestone weathering process is known as the chemical weathering. Whereas in the biological case of weathering, organisms secrete some acids that were, those acids were reacted with the rocks, and rocks were broken into pieces. Because of that, organism secrete acid, the rock broken into number of pieces. This is known as the biological activity. For example, for biological activity, mining is one of the important best example for biological weathering. Biological weathering, due to the humans were, you know, very greedy in their needs, and they want more from, you know, nature. That's why mining activity is going. And due to this mining, rocks were physically broken because of the humans. Human is nothing but an organism. So human is nothing but a big organism. That's why humans are playing a crucial role in the biological weathering. In the case of biological weathering, mining is one of the important example. Okay, mining is one of the important example. So types of weathering we discussed, and we are moving to the first, that is mechanical weathering. In mechanical weathering is the physical disintegration. I already told you, physical disintegration, reduction in size of the rocks without changing their chemical composition. For example, exfoliation, frost wedging, salt wedging, temperature changes, and abrasion. Because of these things, mechanical weathering will take place. In mechanical weathering, please remember, in mechanical weathering, there is no chemical activity. There will not be any chemical activity in mechanical weathering. So please note that mechanical weathering is nothing but physical. So mechanical weathering, nothing but a physical weathering. Nothing but any chemical changes will take place in mechanical weathering, and rock will broken into smaller pieces by the external force only. Examples for the mechanical weathering is exfoliation, frost wedging, salt wedging, temperature changes, and abrasion. We'll move into the next slide. So mechanical weathering, first one is exfoliation. Exfoliation is a mechanical weathering process whereby pressure in a rock is released along the parallel alignments near the surface of the breakdown bedrock, and layers or slabs of the rock along these alignments break off from the bedrock and move downhill by gravity. So exfoliation, as simple as that, under the influence of temperature in the night time, rocks will be contracted, whereas in the daytime rocks will be expanded because of the temperature changes. Because of the temperature changes, rocks will be contracted, rocks will be expanded. So due to this continuous expansion and contraction, rocks outer layer will broken into number of pieces, and it loses its strength. It loses its strength because of the continuous expansion and continuous contraction. That's why the rocks which were there in the high temperature region, they experience more temperature. They got, you know, they absorb more temperature in the daytime, and they release that entire temperature in the night time. Due to this unusual contraction and expansion, the outer layer of that rock will be broken into number of pieces. This kind of weathering is known as the exfoliation. Exfoliation is very high in desert regions. In the desert regions, temperatures in the daytime rises up to 50 degrees. In the nighttime, temperatures of that same desert region falls to the minus degrees. Because of this non-uniform temperature changes in the desert regions, the rocks were there in the desert regions highly affected by the exfoliation process. So you are seeing this thing, this is a very highly temperature area. This rock, this thing is exposed to the surface and experiencing so much of temperature in the nighttime, so much of temperature in the daytime, and so much of temperature loss in day nighttime. That's why the outer layer gets, you know, it's lost its strength, and those outer layer broken into pieces, and under the influence of gravity, these broken pieces were carried out to the downstream region. Under the influence of gravity. Okay. We'll move to the next slide. Next, mechanical weathering. Second example is frost wedging. Frost means nothing but ice. Frost wedging, a mechanical weathering process caused by the freeze-thaw action of water that is trapped between cracks in the rock. When water freezes, it expands and applies pressure to the surrounding the rock, forming the rock to accommodate the expansion of the ice. This process of gradually weakens the cracks and breaks the rock through respective freeze thaw and water weathering layers. So simply, frost wedging nothing but ice. Whenever the ice formed in the cracks of a rock, so whenever the volume changes from liquid to the solid, the volume increases 9%. Because of that, you know, increase in the volume, these ice exerts some pressure on this crack and this side and this side. This side and this side, it exerts some pressure. That's why the crack will be widened. Because of these cracks, again, the extra water will add in the daytime. In the nighttime, it will freezes again, and it forms somewhat larger cone from this image to this image. This tells you that volume is increasing, and that increased volume exerts pressure on these cracks of a rock. If the process goes on increasing, every daytime the water is adding, and every nighttime that extra water which was added in the daytime converted into the ice. That extra ice exerts pressure, extra pressure on the cracks. So in some days, the two pieces were separated. Likewise, these two pieces were separated, and this known as the frost wedging weathering. In this frost wedging, there is no chemical reaction happened between the ice and this rock. Ice and rock and water and rock. This attached piece from first here, it is broken into two pieces. That's why under the influence of this ice, the two pieces, the jointed pieces, the jointed piece separated into two pieces. This is known as the frost wedging weathering. Under the influence of gravity, under the influence of water, under the influence of air, these broken pieces were carried from one place to the another place. Okay, from one place to the another place. This is known as the frost wedging. Frost wedging is simply is nothing but in the daytime. In the daytime, in the daytime, on the top. On the tops of the mountain regions, the water simply enters into the cracks of a rock. Enters into the cracks of a rock. Whereas in the night time, because of the falling in the temperatures, the entered water in the rock cracks converted into the ice. Whenever the water, you know, converts into the water to the solid, that is nothing but liquid to the solid form, changes into liquid to the solid form, it exerts pressure on the cracks of a rock. That's why that exerts extra pressure will broke the rock into number of pieces. That's why frost wedging will place an important role in the high mountain regions which were covered with ice. And polar regions, these frost wedging is very high in the polar regions also. Okay, I hope you frost wedging will be understood by you. By seeing these diagrams, you are clearly known that whenever the water enters into the cracks in the high mountain regions in the night time, that water converts into the ice, and that extra water converts into the ice, which exerts some pressure on the walls of rock, and that due to that extra pressure, it broken into the number of pieces. This is known as the frost wedging. These pieces were carried from one place to the other place under the influence of gravity, under the influence of water flows, under the influence of air. And the broken pieces were deposited somewhere else where the suitable location they got. Okay, this is known as the frost wedging. Simply know that in mechanical weathering, there is no chemical reaction between weathered material. Okay. Next slide. Temperature changes. Daily, diurnal and seasonal temperature changes affect the certain minerals and facilitates the mechanical weathering of bedrocks. So warmer temperatures may cause some minerals to expand and cooler temperatures cause them to contract. This gradual expansion and contraction of mineral grains weakens the rock, causing it to break apart to smaller fragments into fragments. This process is more common in desert climates because they experience extreme fluctuation in daily temperature changes. Temperature changes are not the dominant from weathering. Just instead, temperature changes tend to accelerate other forms of weathering already occurring. Okay, because I already told you about this slide in the previous slide, exfoliation. In desert regions, temperature changes, the diurnal temperature changes was very high. In daytime, the temperature may go up to 50 degrees. In nighttime, the same temperature fallen to the minus degrees. That's why in these temperature changes, rocks will broken into number of pieces because they are experiencing, non-uniform temperatures within a short period of time. That's why the outer layer of that rock lost its strength and broken into number of pieces, and those number of pieces were carried out to the downstream side by the under the influence of gravity, air or water. Okay, next thing is mechanical weathering, and the next thing is salt wedging. Salt wedging occurs when salt crystallizes out of solution as a water evaporates. As a salt crystal grows, they apply pressure to the surrounding rock, rock weakening it until it eventually cracks and breaks down, so enabling the salt crystals to continuously growing. Salt wedging is more common in a drier climate such as deserts. So this thing is also like exfoliation. Whenever the salt water enters into cracks, whenever the salt water enters into the cracks of a rock, if the temperatures are goes on increasing, salt water will evaporate from that water will evaporate from that crack, and salt is growing, accumulation is takes place, and salt is growing or salt is crystallizing. In that crystallization process, it exerts some pressure on the both the walls of that crack. So due to that increased pressure, rock will broken into pieces because to give space to the crystallization of salt mineral. So salt mineral crystallization cubic system, that nothing but a cube. It forms like a Rubik cube. Okay, because the salts will forms as a cubes or crystallize in a cubes, those things will apart, the cracks of the rocks will apart because to give room to the crystallization process, so salt wedging is common in drier regions, okay, such as deserts. Salt wedging common in drier regions such as deserts. Next, mechanical weathering, abrasion. So abrasion occurs when the rock collide against each other, nothing but if under the influence of water, rocks were carried out from one place to the other place. In that journey, one rock, it will meet with another rock, and it will broke with it. The rock pieces broken themselves by the action of abrasion. Abrasion means nothing but they collide each other under influence of this water. Because of this water, the huge rocks blocks will broken into the number of pieces because of the abrasion. So I'm reading out the definition there in that slide. Abrasion occurs when rocks collide against each other while they are transported by water, glacial, ice or wind or gravitational force. During abrasion, rocks may also weather to bedrock surface. They are coming into contact as well as breaking into smaller particles and eventually individual grains. Okay, they may be huge blocks. In the next journey, it broke into smaller pieces, in the next journey, it broke into sand particles, in the next journey, it broke into silt, in the next journey, it broke into number of clay pieces. Okay, the size of a huge block reduces when it is traveling from longer distances, when it is traveled by the longer distances by the water. Okay, because of the vibration, huge blocks collide with each other and these huge blocks, the collision takes place between the huge blocks, and the huge blocks will turn themselves into the smaller pieces. Those smaller pieces turn themselves into the small pieces. Okay, the size reduction will be there in the case of abrasion. Mechanical weathering, salt wedging, we already seen salt wedging. Then we will move to the chemical weathering. So before going to chemical weathering, I would like to give these things from first onwards. Okay, weathering is nothing but a breakdown of rocks. So definition of for weathering is simply a breakdown of rocks. Simply you will see the breakdown of rocks under the influence of mechanical weathering, under the influence of chemical weathering, under the influence of biological weathering, whatever the weathering it may be, weathering means breakdown of rocks. Weathering means breakdown of the number of categorizations were there, but the best categorization which were you are showing on the screen, computer screen now, mechanical weathering, chemical weathering, biological weathering, and differential weathering. Maybe if any weathering fit in this these things, it will comes under differential weathering. Definition: weathering is nothing but a physical breakdown of types of weathering: mechanical weathering, chemical weathering, biological weathering. And mechanical weathering, exfoliation is there, frost wedging is there, salt wedging is there, and temperature changes were there, abrasion were there, and mechanical weathering, exfoliation was there, and frost wedging is there, and temperature changes will there. And temperature changes causes a rock to break itself by the huge temperature changes. And the chemical weathering, in the next class we will see the chemical weathering. Today the class is over. I hope you all of you are good in your homes. Don't go outside for silly reasons. Don't go outside for silly reasons. It is my sincere request for you. Don't spend your precious time by unnecessary activities. Use this precious time to grow in your life. So I hope weathering process you understood, and tomorrow we will discuss about the chemical weathering. So you may not be habituated to see the online classes from your childhood onwards. Now these online classes were very good and new to you, but we are having only this thing only to learn the subject. And JNTU Kakinada already started the academic year, and you have to follow the suggestion, you have to follow the orders which JNTU Kakinada has given to the college. That's why college is conducting under the college is working under the guidance of JNTU Kakinada. The guidelines of JNTU Kakinada should be valid by the MVR College of Engineering Technology. That's why don't go outside for silly reasons. And I hope you are using this time for good things and good deeds. Thank you very much. Don't waste your time for silly reasons. Use masks, use hand sanitizers. Quickly clean your hands after coming home from outside. Thank you all.